How do we use bits? We can count. 0000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 And a good example of this is the barcode for things you buy in the supermarket. Got a little barcode. If you look at the barcodes, it's a series of lines. The lines are a bunch of narrow lines, and then there's some thicker lines in between. And the idea is that each of these narrow lines is a zero, each of these thicker lines is a one. So this barcode that I actually drew for you right here is in fact a barcode that says 00011001. It's a number in binary. But each item in the supermarket has its own specific barcode that says, hey, it's just a label that says, this is an apple, a gala apple from Washington State. Sorry, or this is a box of all brand buds. So the label, we can use these bits as labels, and now you see how the power of information comes in. Because with a relatively small number of bits, we can label a very, very large number of things. To get a sense for how many things we can label with bits, let's note the following feature. So 2 to the 10th, which is equal to 2 times 2 times dot, 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 times 2, 10 times. This is 2 raised to the power 10, which is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 in binary. Is actually equal to 1,024 in digits. That is to say, 2 to the 10th is approximately equal to 10 to the 3rd, a little more than 1,000, 1,000 plus change. Actually, in the old days with computers, when you bought a computer and you say, oh, I bought a computer with, 1,000 bits of memory, that's what how, you know, old computers had a very small amount of memory. It didn't mean 1,000, a kilobit. It meant 1,024 bits. So a megabyte, a byte, by the way, is equal to 8 bits. A megabyte was a computer with not just a million bits of memory, but an extra 2.4% for free. Sadly, a few years ago, the computer companies realized the error of their ways and they stopped giving you this extra bonus. It's terrible. Like, you call this progress. In progress, you know, information processing, Microsoft Word 95 was significantly easier to use than Microsoft Word today, which shows you the perils of information processing. So, if we have these 10 to the 90 particles, that's approximately equal to 2 to the 300 elementary particles in the universe. This is the total number of particles in the universe. And because there are 2 to the 300 particles, that means that a barcode for each particle, if we wanted to make a barcode to label every elementary particle in the universe, now it's not really quite clear like where we would put this barcode on your elementary particles, but if you could put a barcode on its elementary particles, that means that 300 bits suffice to label every elementary particle in the universe. So I say, well, I want this microwave photon over here, and they take this microwave photon, it's got a 300-bit barcode, and they put it on the scanner. Yes, here's your microwave photon, sir. That will be $300. Well, inflation has also taken its toll over the last few decades. So you see that information can be measured independent of what it means. We can count things, and because we can count things, we can label them with digits or with bits. And with a very small number of bits, we can label a huge number of things. 300 bits suffice to label every elementary particle in the universe. By contrast, if you look at DNA, 3 billion base pairs of DNA, and there are four possibilities for each base pair, and that means 2 bits per pair, which means that there are 6 billion bits in the human DNA. This is way, 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 way more amount of information than is required to label every single elementary particle in the universe. And what do these bits represent in DNA? They represent possibility. They represent the different possible genetic combinations which could program what we do. Now, of course, most of these bits, the vast majority of these bits, are programming just kind of elementary processes about, you know, chemical reactions in our cells. We share most of these bits with yeast. And we share 99% of our bits with other primates like chimpanzees, 99.8% of our bits with other human beings, but that extra little tiny bit makes that extra difference, the difference that makes a difference.